electrochemistry. Okay, electrochemistry and chemical kinetics. Chemical kinetics. Okay, so this is your physical chemistry branch. So in that, we are first to discuss about first topic, that is electrochemistry. Okay, so generally there are two topics are there. One is electrochemistry and chemical kinetics. In that first topic, that is electrochemistry. So in that electrochemistry, this electrochemistry is belongs to physical chemistry branch. Okay, it is belongs to physical chemistry branch. So this chemical kinetics also belongs to same branch, but electrochemistry and chemical kinetics both are different. Next, in this electrochemistry, we discuss about conversion. Okay, so generally conversion, the conversion of electrical energy, the conversion of electrical energy into chemical energy. Electrical energy into chemical energy means the conversion of electrical energy into chemical energy is a process. That process is explained by electrochemistry. This electrochemistry, in this electrochemistry we discuss for some terms. So important terms, so those terms are very useful in electrochemistry branch. So in that, first one is conductor. Okay, first branch, the first term is conductor, means a substance, the substance which allows electricity, the substance which allows electricity through in it is called as conductor. So this conductor example is aqueous solution, the aqueous solution of acid or base or salt. Okay, so these are the examples of conductors, means these conductors are allows electricity through in it. Okay, second one is non-conductors. Okay, non-conductors, so these substances do not allows electricity through in it. Okay, for example is wood or paper. Okay, so these are sometimes carbon. Okay, these all are the examples of non-conductors, means the conductors allows electricity through in it, those are called as conductors. The substance do not allows electricity is called as non-conductors. And next term is very important term, this is electrolyte. Okay, electrolyte. Okay, electrolyte means one chemical substance. For example, your chemical substance is AB. This AB chemical substance is undergoes in aqueous solution. In presence of aqueous solution, it produces two types of ions. One is cation and one is anion. Okay, this plus, the plus indicates cation. This is cation, this is anion. Okay, means the chemical substance in presence of aqueous solution produce two types of ions. One is cation and one is anion. So electrolyte means in presence of electric current. In presence of electric current, the chemical substance undergoes decomposition. Undergoes decomposition is called as electrolyte. Okay, now these electrolytes, generally electrolytes are classified into two types. Okay, one is strong electrolyte and second one is weak electrolyte. So in that, first one is strong electrolyte. Strong electrolyte. Strong electrolyte means the substance, the chemical substance completely dissociated. Completely dissociated under flowing of current. Completely dissociated under flowing of current, which produce high conductance. which produce high conductance at moderate concentration. At moderate concentration is called a strong electrolyte. Means the chemical substance completely dissociated at moderate concentration and high conductance is called a strong electrolyte. For this strong electrolyte, example is strong acid. Okay, the best example is strong acid, or next one is strong base. Okay. So in this lesson, the strong acid example is HCl, or you consider sulfuric acid, hydrochloric acid, or sulfuric acid. Strong base, the strong base example is sodium hydroxide. Okay, and second one is weak electrolyte. Okay, the chemical substance which partially dissociated. The partially dissociated at low conductance. At low conductance at moderate condition is called as weak electrolyte. For this weak electrolyte, example is weak acid. Okay. Say first example is weak acid. Second example is weak base. For this weak acid, the weak acid example is acetic acid. Acetic acid. That acetic acid formula is CH3COOH. Weak base. The weak base example is NH4OH, ammonium hydroxide.